basically they come along just to check on your welfare at the moment, see if you need any medical assistance or anything because of your hunger strike.
Well, you can see from my website what I've done.
Well, it's a lot easier to see from in person, isn't it? So, at the moment, Bob, do you need any medical assistance?
I have got medical assistance that is not sufficient because of what the Commissioner and the Mayor are doing. That's why I've put it on the website. I've put on the website what the problem is, the problem they're causing to my health. I've put it there. I've said I want in black and white them to go on the public record why they're preventing us from having tents, then I will challenge them through the courts.
We are aware that you've got an ongoing legal process in relation to your property.
No. If you check out my website, you'll see that they've ignored what I've asked and they need to go on the public record now because this is my life. I've got the medical records to prove it. You know, this is my life they're messing with. They need to go on the public record so we can challenge them in the courts. That's the proper way of doing things, isn't it, gentlemen?
Well, what we're doing with... Do you need an ambulance? Do you need to go to hospital at the moment? If you do, we'll arrange it for you.
Well, we're quite capable of phoning 999 when the time comes.
You've looked at the website. You know what the health issues are.
So I've seen the website and I've been copied into some documents that you've sent to the High Court.
You've seen the medical record that I put on the website. You understand the implications of them leaving me out in the freezing cold without a tent. I want them to go on the public record, which they're legally obliged to do, and then we'll challenge it through the courts. They need to say what their reasons, and I'll take them to court over it. They need to actually say the reasons. It's not good enough to send you down here to say nothing. They need to put it in writing on the public record. They're legally obliged to.
I think that there is a legal process which
they're ignoring. They are ignoring. I'm on hunger strike because they are ignoring the legal process.
Well, I don't think we would have been sent down here with advice.
Sorry?
No, we are going to come down on a regular basis to check on you, Barbara, but it's purely...
we all know I am going to die here. We know I am going to die here because of my medical condition, which they are ignoring. I want to hear their excuses why.
The thing with it is, there's a legal process that has to be gone through, okay? And with every sort of legal process, speed is not the law's greatest asset.
Well, it is really, because I remember Maria Galastegui, she got an injunction just like that.
Also, you had 28 days to prosecute or return the property. That is your law.
Yeah.
So where is the property?
I don't know, is the honest answer. I don't know where the property is.
Well, we've done everything that we need to be, but what I want on public record is the Mayor and the Commissioner's reason for failing to return it. And I can challenge that through the courts. That's the legal process, because really, here's how the game plays out. These little dears over here write a load of nonsense. What they expect is that 99% of the public will go along with it. When the 1% of the public says, well, actually, what is a reasonable excuse? They go, oh dear, now we've got to dream up something. I've seen it all before with the previous law where there was no power of seizure and I was just served the documents and civil claim about that, where I was unlawfully arrested then. I get how the game plays. The previous law, you know SOCRA?
Yep.
They go, 99% of the people will go along with what we say. Someone questions it, what are we going to do? Pretend that section 3.1 is a police power of seizure. Guys, that was a joke. I get how the game plays. But they're playing it, the Mayor and the Commissioner are playing a game with my life here, and I'm not impressed.
Well, as part of that legal process, we've been asked to just clarify your legal representation. Because I think there's Baird's and Wayman's, is it?
Neil Kerslake and Steve Jago have my power of attorney should anything happen to me.
So in terms
of... So they will instruct my lawyers if there is a problem with me.
I'm trying to get into my own head. Perhaps I'm being just a bit daft, and if I am, I do apologise.
No, it is.
But you're represented by Bird solicitors. But which aspect are they representing you for? Is it you trying to get your property back? Or is it you trying to say that the law that's been passed that says you can't have a tent here is wrong? Or which bit? I'm trying to figure that bit out.
Do you need a couple of quid for drink or something?
Okay.
Thanks, Chief.
They are happy to deal with property being returned to us. Birds have told me that. They will write to the Commissioner as well if it's necessary, but there's no point in doing that until the Mayor and the Commissioner come out with their reasons for not returning it. Because obviously I'm happy about returning it. So a simple letter from the lawyers asking why, you know, or can they return it, is not going to do anything. the mayor and the commissioner need to say why they're not returning stuff. Maria Galestegui got a High Court injunction within days, had her case heard within 3 months. They were designed to lose. That case was designed to lose. I've been trying to get a case heard somewhere, for anywhere, for 366 days. I even put in an application last week at Southwark Crown Court for the commissioner, the mayor of London.
Crown Court and High Court are two very different things.
Oh, we've been everywhere.
I've been everywhere. I've been to the High Court. Yeah. They put a stay on my civil claim over everything that was taken on January the 16th last year. They put a stay on that. Now, why would you put a stay on something where I'm not being prosecuted?
That's a High Court's decision. It's not
no, it's
decision.
Not. It comes from across the road there. Well, this is dirty politics.
If you've gone to court and they put a stay on it, then it's the High Court making the decision, isn't it?
Well, the Attorney General took down a recording of what was really said in the courts because it's purely political.
I wasn't there, so...
Well, if you drive to France, you can watch the video. It's available there. It's available everywhere except this country.
And they were covering up what was really said, because the emails that were used in the other person's High Court case, the emails from when I was arrested on the 16th and 17th of January, show, and this will embarrass you guys, the Home Secretary was nobbling the High Court judges. The Home Secretary was emailing around telling them, hurry up, cover up the illegal seizure on January the 16th. So let's be honest, this is about politics. They're influencing your commissioner, your mayor. They're the ones that have to go on the public record today. I'm asking them to do it because I don't want to die of a heart attack in the freezing cold.
No.
You know, so they will be responsible. You look at the figures. Hunger strike, I've acted really sensibly. My medical condition, they're acting, you know, illegally. That's the truth of it, legally speaking, gentlemen. Thank you.